A very warm welcome to another video. Today we'll be talking about Adobe Illustrator. If you want to learn Adobe Illustrator or you are just getting started with Adobe Illustrator, then this video is for you. All you have to do is to watch this video till the very end, because with this video I'm going to help you get started with Adobe Illustrator. And really quick, I have to say a very big thank you to our new subscribers. So if you're just joining us, welcome to the channel. Here we do lots of graphic design videos, and we do videos around graphic design tutorials and tips and tricks to help you be the best you can be as a graphic designer. You guys are so amazing, and welcome to the channel. I think we have more people from India and more people from USA. Hello to you all from India and from USA. Welcome to the channel. So in order to avoid a long and boring video, I've divided this video into three series so you can follow it up step by step and get started with Adobe Illustrator. In the first series, we'll be talking about introduction to Adobe Illustrator and Adobe Illustrator interface. And in the second series, we'll be talking about shortcuts you should know in Adobe Illustrator and how to make a simple design with Adobe Illustrator. And in the last series, we'll be talking about how to save jobs and export for print in Adobe Illustrator. So you see, this video has lots of packages for you, so make sure you watch this video till the very end. And if you find this video helpful, make sure you leave a like and share this video with a friend. Just so you know, Adobe Illustrator is a vector-based program, so we'll be doing vector-based designs with Adobe Illustrator, and every design you will see me do with Adobe Illustrator will be vector-based design. So when using Adobe Illustrator, it should be depending on the type of designs you do. It's not a must that you use Adobe Illustrator for only illustrations, just like what you can see. For me, I'm not really good at making illustrations like this, but I use Adobe Illustrator for all my vector-based flyer designs, just like this one. But if you like to know more about Adobe Illustrator, I would recommend you watch this video just right here, and then you can also watch this video as well. But then don't click on the video yet until you finish watching this one. When you are done, I'll leave a link on the description so you can watch this video right here. Then we get started with Adobe Illustrator. So let's get started. So once you open up Adobe Illustrator, this is what you see. And here you see a lot of options to trigger what you want to do next, either to start a project or to open a project. If you want to create a new project, you click on create new just here. And if you want to open a previous project, you click on open. And then you further see some presets of sizes you like to start your artboard, okay? You see some presets, and if you click on more presets, you will see more presets. And just here, you see your recent project. If you have ever designed with Adobe Illustrator, this is where you see your recent project. Okay, so let's move on to more presets. Let's see what we have there. So when you click on more presets, this is what you see. But then let's do it this way. You click on create new. When you click on create new, it still takes you to where you still have the more presets. Okay, then when you have the recent, here you have previous sizes you have used for your designs, okay? And here where you have saved, you have where you have saved your previous sizes. And funny enough, I've not saved any size here before, okay? So you click on mobile. When you click on mobile, you see different sizes for mobile designs, either iPhone X or iPhone 8, 7, 6 Plus, iPhone 8, 7 and 6, iPad Pro, and so on. So it depends on the type of design you're doing. So if you are designing maybe a UI or UX design, you definitely need this for your mobile phone interface, okay, or your mobile phone experience. And if you are designing for the web, this is where you have all the sizes for your web designs, okay. And for print, you definitely need this, like the letter A4, print large, and so on. You definitely need this for your print designs. And if you are designing for film and video, this is where you have all the sizes. If you are designing for a 4K and so on, for people that are interested in motion graphics, you will definitely need this, okay? And for art and illustrations, all the presets for art and illustrations asset here. But then we are going to move direct to what we'll be doing next. I'm going to click on print. You know, I'm a print designer, so I do lots of print designs. And then you click on print, and fine, you have all the presets for print. So I'm going to choose A4. And when you click on A4, you see your preset details are all here. So you set your width. If you want to make a custom design, you can set your width here, and you set your size, your height here, and you have your orientation, either landscape or portrait. So I'm going to leave mine on landscape. Okay, so this is where you have your landscape view or portrait view. That's for your orientation. And you choose how many artboard you like. If you want to design on a 2 or 3 artboard, you can set how many artboards you need here. And then you can also set the unit you want to design with here, either points or pixels. I like designing with pixels a lot, or inches. So you choose either pixel, points, pickers, inches, feet, and so on. You choose your unit here. So that's cool. Then we move on, and like that, you see your blade, where you can set your blade to the top, to the left, bottom, and right. And this blade is best for print designs. If you are designing a job for print, then definitely you need to set your blade here. But we're going to leave that for further tutorials we'll be doing around print designs. So I'm going to talk more about the blade. But let's move on to the next one, where we have the color mode. The color mode is the workspace you actually want to work with. If you want to learn more about color mode or work color space, you definitely need to watch this video just here. Okay, it's actually on the channel, so I'm going to leave a link down below also, so you watch video about color mode or color space. So this is the color mode we like to work with. Since it's a print design, I'm going to leave it at CMYK. And I would like you to know more about how to work with RGB and when to use RGB in our coming videos. Okay, so let's move on. Then the next one you need to see is the raster effect. Now the raster effect is actually the quality you want to work with. When you choose 300 ppi, you definitely design at 300 ppi, your design is going to come out with high quality. So if you're designing for print, you need to use 300 ppi, and if you are designing for screen or any other purpose, like something that will end on the screen, then you need to use either 72 or 150 ppi. But for this, I'm going to leave it at 300. I've never dreamt of designing on a low quality. I like designing with high quality, and that is 300. Okay, so let's move on. And you see the preview mode on default, is it pixel or overprint? But let's just leave this at default. Then if you click on more settings, you see other more settings, even more than what we've done in a kind of this dialog box, where you have all the settings here. It's pretty much the same as the preset details we just finished. So let's just cancel this and click on create. And once you click on create, your artboard opens up just like this, and this is what you see. And we're going to study the interface according to their sections. And the first interface we'll be looking at will be our menu bar. And this is where we have our menu bar, where we have the file, we have edit, we have object, we have type, we have select, we have effect, we have view, windows, and help. And then you need to know more about the menu bar, but one note you should take is that you won't get better right from the start. Just look at what I have on this studio. You have to say it, because this looks like my watchword that says skills get better with every trial. It's always here because this stuff motivates me a lot. So skills gets better with every trial. So every day you open Adobe Illustrator, you get better at using it. You might not know everything in this single video, but this single video is good enough to bring you up from a very beginner to a good professional. But you may not arrive at the professional stage just immediately, but skills get better with each trial. Okay, let's move on. So you have your file. When you click on file, you see this drop down where you have the new. You can create a new artboard, a new workspace or project with this. Okay, you have new from template. So when you create a new, you click on Shift Control N, you create new from template, and it will still take us back to the templates we were creating before. You see open recent, and pretty much all this stuff are what we always see in other softwares we use. So it's not gonna be a new stuff to us. You have your close all, save a copy, and I'm going to let you know when to use each of these commands, okay? So it's very much easy. And you have save as template. When you click on save as template, it takes us to where you have to save a particular template so you can use it again and again and again. So you have other commands like revert, search stock, Adobe stock, place, and export selection, package script, and a lot of information just dropped down here, including print and exit. That looks really nice and very nice. So let's move on. Next one you see here is the edit, where you have undo, redo, cut, copy, paste in front. And then in our videos, we'll be talking about shortcuts you need to know about Adobe Illustrator. I will talk more about all these shortcuts and how to get this stuff done very fast. Okay, so let's see the next one, find and replace. This way you can find a particular text and replace. And with time, you get to know how to use more of this, but I'm not going to go into full detail tutorial since this is just the introduction. So you just need to know where to find all these, to check your spellings, correct auto spell check and check spellings, edit custom dictionary, edit colors, and this is where you have to recolor your artwork, adjust your color balance, blend horizontally, convert to CMYK, convert to grayscale, and lot more. And you see edit originals. So when it comes to edit originals, this is where you'll be able to edit maybe an image you brought into Illustrator. When you click on edit original, and this works with only linked images. I know I might be saying things you don't understand, but when we proceed, you get to know this. But let's just understand a simple stuff here. Working with linked images, it means an object or an image you bring to Adobe Illustrator is directly linked from a particular source. So when you click on Edit Original, it takes you to the source where the image is gotten from. So imagine that if the image is a Photoshop image, when you click on Edit Original, it takes you to Photoshop where you have to edit your image there in Photoshop. And when you save, it applies automatically to Adobe Illustrator. And this is because Adobe Illustrator is not a raster-based program. It's a vector-based program. So you have limited options to edit images. And this is why Edit Original is found in Adobe Illustrator. So let's move on. You see other options where you have the transparency or flattener and so on. And lots more we'll be looking at in our subsequent tutorials. And for this, you see keyboard shortcut. So you can as well teach yourself the shortcut by coming to keyboard shortcuts. It's very simple. Then if you need to set anything in your software, Adobe Illustrator, you come to My Settings, Export and Import Settings. And if you click on Preferences, that is if there is anything working the way you don't want it to work, then you come to Preferences and you're able to set them here using preferences. Okay, let's move on to objects. And now if you're working with a particular object in Illustrator, this is where you'll be able to transform, arrange, align, group, ungroup, lock, and so on. All this stuff are here. Fine. And type, when you're working with your typeface, you want to edit your type, edit a paragraph, and so on. This is where you get all the settings. Select, when working with objects, you want to select or deselect or reselect and so on. This is where you get that. And under effects, this is where you have every Illustrator effect you want to apply on a particular object in Adobe Illustrator. This is where you get all the effects done. And under view, you will set everything about your workspace, your ruler guides, and your so on, and zoom in, zoom out, and every stuff you need to set while working to make your work flow easy. This is where you get that under your view, okay? And Windows is where you arrange. Now, every stuff you see on my Windows, on this workspace, all of them are found on the Windows, including how my drop down
is here. Okay, that's really cool. Okay, let's move on. So the next thing you see here is help, where you, if you encounter any challenge with Adobe Illustrator, the help option will help you to fix it out. So pretty much that's a little like an expose you to with the menu bar. So everything about Windows would be how we perceive our workspace to look like, or it should be how we want to customize our workspace to look like. Now let's take a look at this. I've customized my layers to be on this angle. And if I want to deactivate this, I'll simply come to Windows. And when I click on Windows, you see the drop down where you have layers, then you click on layers, then automatically that is where you have your layers. And I can still take this off there. Now, there is no layer in my workspace, but I can come to Windows and click on layers and it appears. Then you can pick it and drop it wherever you want it to be. And that's where I've placed my layers. Same thing applies to every other stuff you see on my workspace. Pretty much anyhow you want to customize your workspace should be on your Windows, and that much. And the next thing we want to look at on studying the interface of Adobe Illustrator should be layers. Now, working with layers in Adobe Illustrator is very, very important because you really need it to organize your workspace. Remember when we talked about Adobe Illustrator and Adobe Photoshop, I mentioned that layers in Illustrator is very important and that you can work with multiple layers and you can also work with one layer for multiple objects, and that looks cool. Let's look at layers this way. Let's take a look at this artwork here. Okay, pretty much this artwork was not done by me, but it's a perfect example for what I want to show you. Now, there are a lot of things going on this artwork and much more to know that all this stuff are laid on just two layers. It's laid on two layers compared to that of Photoshop that every object comes with its own layer, okay? And at the end, you will end up having up to hundreds of layers for just an artwork in Photoshop. But in Illustrator, you see that all the layers here, or all the objects here, are laid into just two layers. Let's take a look. So I'll come to my layer panel where I have just the first and the second layer. Let's see this. Now, the first layer, layer two, comes with the text. It's the layer that has the text, while the top layer has the artwork itself, the illustration itself. Okay, so this is the illustration on layer one and the text on layer two. So you can separate your layers just like this. Okay, so if I click on this drop down, you see what is made up of all this stuff. So each layer comes with its own color. Let's look at this. The first layer has a blue color, so every object on layer one has this blue color just here, okay? And then layer two comes with red color, and every object in layer two comes with the color just there. So if I bring this down, you see all the layers here. Now, if you don't have this layers panel on your workspace, you can come to Windows and click on layers, and then you have it on your workspace. That's how it's customized. Same thing happens to every other stuff you want to see on your workspace. Okay, let's say you want to see your appearance panel. You click on your Windows and you see appearance. Now, appearance is just the way an object looks like. It's simply the way an object looks like. Now, when you get started with Adobe Illustrator, you get to know some of these terms. And I'm going to make a dedicated video on terms you need to understand in Adobe Illustrator. So when you hear me mention those terms, it's not going to be new to you. Okay, let's move on. So that's about layers. And you see, every object has their layers, but then it's all enclosed into one layer, and that's layer one and layer two. So layer one has the artwork itself and layer two has the text. And that does not mean that all these texts are laid on one layer. They have their separate layers, just like what I've shown you just here. All these texts have their separate layers, but then all are enclosed and embedded to one particular layer, which forms this. And here you are able to drag or move appearance. Like you can see the notification, they click to target and drag to move appearance. You can move the appearance of a particular layer to another layer. That, for example, if a particular layer has a shadow and you want to apply that same shadow to another layer, you click and drag to the top layer, which I'll be doing this much more in our coming tutorials, and that will be nice. So that's what you need to, a little you need to understand about layers, okay, in Adobe Illustrator. And the next stuff you like to study about Adobe Illustrator is the toolbar, which has almost every stuff you need to work in Adobe Illustrator. If you are not familiar with any stuff in Adobe Illustrator, then you should be familiar with the tools, what they are used for, and when to use them. And it's not the most that you need to know how to use all the tools in Adobe Illustrator to be perfect. You just get better with the tools you know and learn how to use them very well. The little amount of tools you know, learn to use them better, okay? It's better you learn how to use two tools perfectly than to use a good number of tools and you master none of them. Okay, let's study the tools one after the other. And the first tool you should get used to is the selection tool, and the shortcut for that is V. Okay, selection tool, and that's the tool you should use to click and select any object you want in Adobe Illustrator. And next tool just right beside the selection tool is the direct selection tool. Now let's take a look at what direct selection tool is. Now look at this artwork. It has a lot of things going on here, but then you want to select a particular stuff in this artwork. With the help of your selection tool, you can select the whole artwork, but direct selection tool will help you select a particular object. Take example, I want to select this green. You click. Now I'm able to select just this object and move it. Okay, that's what direct selection tool does. Okay, and I want to select just this magenta. You click and shift that, and that's just it. So that's what direct selection tool does. Okay, and the next stuff you like to know is this other tool, magic wand tool. It pretty much works like the magic wand tool you know in Adobe Illustrator. And the next one is the lasso tool, your paint tool, and your curvature tool, your text tool, which are the most important tools you should know. For a graphic designer just like me that deals with flyer, you should learn to use your selection tool, your group selection tool, your pen tool, your line tool, your text tool, and your rectangle tool. These tools are tools you need to familiarize yourself with, and many much more tools here. And another tool you should learn to use is the gradient tool. Now I can't move out to start explaining each of these tools one after the other, okay? But as we proceed and start using these tools to make designs, you get to know better about all these tools. But I'm just exposing you guys to where you can find the tools, and that each tool has their own function, and just for you to have a little idea about all these tools. And the next thing you want to know about Adobe Illustrator interface is the option bar. And this is where we have the option bar. Now, everything you click in Adobe Illustrator comes with its own option. It gives you option of what to do and what you should do with a particular object you select. Okay, let's say I'm going to ungroup this. You right click and click on ungroup, and I have every object. Now if I select this object, I have different options to tell me what I can do with that object, either to align it to the left, align to the right, align to the top, align to the center. Now, whichever option you choose, and then you have other options like to give it stroke, okay, a color of stroke and so on, working with stroke, and you can also give it a brush definition and opacity. If you want to adjust the opacity, you can use every stuff here working on the option bar. Now, if you see, observe, if I click out the option bar, I have other options just on a default, okay, then you have, when you click on this stuff, you also have other options there. And then that is just what the option bar does. And look right down here. Every move you take, you have the quick actions that records every move you take, and you can repeat that move. Like I just did the ungroup move, and this is where I have the quick actions where I can, if I need to ungroup again, I will simply on Groovy because I've done the move already. That's what the quick actions does. And options bar is just right here. And the next thing we want to look at is the panels. And this is where we have the panels. Okay, we have every single panel that help you to work better in Adobe Illustrator. So the properties panel has the property of your artboard. And if you want to edit your artboard, for example, I click on edit artboard, I'm able to change the size of my artboard just here. So you can bring your cursor just up here and click here. And you see different sizes you can give to your artboard. And you can also make it a portrait or a landscape, just as how you want this to look like. Okay, and you can click here, new artboard, to add on this plus icon. You can click to add a new artboard as many as you want. Okay, the more you click, the more you get new artboard. So I'm going to delete all this stuff by clicking just here, and you delete all those artboard. That's just it. Okay, if you click on preset, you still see other sizes. It's still the same routine of ads clicking here. Okay, it's just that. And when you are done editing your artboard, and don't forget, you can always hold and edit your artboard on a custom stuff like this. It's very simple. And once you are done with that, you can always click on exit to exit editing your artboard. So this is your properties panel, and you have your libraries. You have other panels you can set on your own to customize your own workspace. By coming to Windows, you can customize your panels to set it the way you want it to look like. And the last thing I'm going to show you about Adobe Illustrator Workspace, and I believe with this, we can get started because you have idea on some of the tools I've shown you and some of the things. And just to let you know how the interface looks like, the next thing I'm going to show you on Adobe Illustrator would be if you are using an older version of Adobe Illustrator or a newer version just like mine, you should try and come to Windows and click on Workspace and Essentials Classic. And this will help you to be on the same page with me because it's going to reset every stuff and makes you to be on the same space. On the same page with me. Okay, that's cool and nice. So if with the help of this video you were able to open up Adobe Illustrator and try out starting something, at least creating a new document and moving around the new document, leave a like on this video and share this video with a friend, because I'll be doing more tutorials around Adobe Illustrator and helping you make a stunning design with Adobe Illustrator. And if you like to know everything about Adobe Illustrator and Adobe Photoshop, click on this video and watch it right now. Thank you so much, and I will see you in the next video.